It's July 28th, and we are headed to Highway 240. We are leaving Cedar Pass Lodge Campground in the Badlands and want to take a scenic view and then hopefully hit a couple of really easy trails. There's only a couple here in the park that you might need 4x4.
There's a lot of prairie dogs out here.
I don't know if it's gonna just be another gravel road or it's actually gonna, you know, be a little more interesting, a little more technical, hopefully. We're gonna check it out. We just opened the gate. I went ahead and sent Haley through, and when you find a gate that is chained, you need to put it back like you found it when you go through. I did check the board here by the gate for restrictions, no fires, stuff like that right now, so we're good to go. We don't plan on camping. We're just seeing the sights. All right. Well, it looks more interesting than a fire road. Thank you. Gotta be careful there, it's a little narrow. Sure that gets washed out all the time. When there's rain. Oh, that's cool. What is this? There was a railroad track
there.
Yeah,
look at the old train track.
I know, isn't that cool? Settlers on the formerly Sioux lands eagerly anticipated the arrival of the railways to this region.
This was an old
before the tracks
track.
Were even laid, they were building shacks on 160-acre tracts of land given them for a registration fee of $10 by the Homestead Act of 1862. These tracks were first completed in 1907 by the railroad company commonly known as Milwaukee Road and ran until they went bankrupt in 1980. It stretched 286 scenic miles from Mitchell to Rapid City, going through the Badlands. Here's a low-quality pic of the last train run leaving Rapid City in March of that year. It would have run across the bridge we see here and another we saw that isn't pictured right off this trail. This line is now owned by the state of South Dakota, who paid a company to salvage the now-missing rails all the way from Kadoka to Rapid City. The line from Mitchell to Kadoka is still in use. Okay, Haley, I talked to those guys, and there is something coming up here where we may tilt towards the driver's side. But he said if we can make it up that, then we should be free and clear after that, as far as any kind of technical challenge, okay?
Okay.
Are you having fun?
There's more prairie dogs to look at on the left right here.
Her favorite part's been the prairie dogs so far. This is better than that gravel road, isn't it? Okay?
I just wait for you.
Alright, take it easy, okay?
You
want to
look at it?
Yeah, I'll hop out. Let's disconnect your sway bar. Push that button down there. That's the sway bar. Okay, it should be disconnected now. It shouldn't have much of any issue getting up there. Ride the left side. Left side. Left side, yep. Keep up there, stay up there. Keep going, keep momentum. Momentum, don't stop. Don't stop, keep going. Yo, keep going, keep going. There we go. Lantern, disconnect. Oh man, that thing's hot. Turn it the right way, Daniel. Disconnected. Only have a rear locker, so it's on. Let me put it 4 high. Should be good. Yeah, and as it's sand. I wanted her sway bar disconnect to work, and it only works in 4 low on hers. Alright, on the move again.
If anyone would happen to know what the pile of rocks up on the left is and why it might be there, please leave a comment and thanks for watching.
See that?
Interesting. It makes you wonder. I think that's a grave or something.